Yesterday, I was at the Old Town. These high school girls came out there, man. Their shirts were so short. Not shirt, their skirts. They had to keep pulling the skirts down. Their ass cheeks kept popping out. Now, who in the fuck would have hooked up with a woman like that? With all her ass on display to the world. So if she's showing her ass like that to the world, she gonna show it and disrespect you too. Who in the hell wanna hook up with that? All of the girls was dressed like that. They had to keep pulling the skirts down and walking like this. You must be out of your goddamn mind to hook up with one of them. I know I wouldn't. If she don't respect herself, how the fuck she gonna respect you? All right, I'm gonna get ready to bring it out. And the men are acting like women. A lot of these men are just effeminate. Oh, yeah, yeah. Yep, I missed it that time. All right, go ahead and bring it out.
There we go.
Right here. I'm gonna face the east. I can give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, Rafak Kadash. Double honor and respect to the elders and the apostles of Great Millstone. Much respect and honor to the brothers that are doing the work in truth and sincerity, risking their lives and freedom to do so, pushing this gospel throughout the four corners of the earth. Salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. Much love and respect to the true men of Israel that are helping to edify the body and feed the lambs daily. Who's doing the work? That's the marks of a man that are out here pushing the gospel. And this is a heavenly wisdom. It's not meant for everybody. That's why most people that come across this gospel, it bugs them out. Their mind can't handle it. Imagine trying to teach a 5-year-old young boy advanced placement calculus or algebraic equations. That child is going to be bugged out and confused. Overwhelmed. That's this gospel. So when you look at to educate, educate comes from the Latin word educare, which means to bring out. So the elect already have the seed, just waiting to be watered by the doctrines and the teachings of the apostles and the gift of the Holy Spirit. That's the sunlight. So the seed is already there. But if you're bugged out, you don't have that seed. The seal of redemption. Or the thawah. Exemption from judgment. So without that seed, imagine pouring water on dry dirt. It's a waste of time. It's just going to evaporate. When the sun hit it, it's going to crack. That's how a lot of these men and women are walking around. Crack pipes. Or crackpots, bugged out. So the seed of the elect is already in our mind, a hopeful elect. So when this doctrine is taught, that's the living waters. See? And then the sun rays hit. That's the Holy Spirit. I just bugged out somebody. That's not in the truth. That's why when you come on our comment board, you either humble down or dash the door. Because if you can't get it, then we know you're not one of us. It's just that simple. So we're gonna go into it. Brother, we're gonna go to 2 Corinthians chapter 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. Make sure I'm not tripping. I think that's the right one. First Corinthians chapter 2. It's a lot here. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. So once again, the seed is that essence of the word of truth. The seed is already pre-planted in the minds of the elect. So what are we reading about? Future world leaders. Well, this wisdom is above the head of the average citizen. So the governors, the remnant, are already pre-selected to assume the thrones, the way ahead, after the destruction to come. Post-apocalyptic order, governors, dominion. Those are the ones that you're seeing stand up in these last days that are teaching. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 1, 1 Corinthians chapter 2. I'm going to start at the top, please, Bubba Kishab.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, and it reads, "And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellence of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of the Most High." Verse 2, "For I determined not to know anything among you, save Yahawashah HaMashiach, and him crucified." Verse 3, and it reads, "And I was with you in weakness, and in fear, and in much trembling." Verse 4, "And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power."
So your PhD degrees that you got at the university, enticing words, elegant speech, has nothing to do with a spiritual doctrine. We're not impressed by a man-made slave degree that you have, a master's degree. Most of us are sick relying on these doctors. We're getting sicker. So this heavenly doctrine, this wisdom from the fourth dimension, it heals our soul, our spirit. So it's not about elegant speech or man-made wisdom. Come on.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 5, and it reads, "That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of the Most High."
Oh, say that again.
"That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of the Most High."
See, so this is not a man-made doctrine. Look at the prophecies that came to pass. The Romans taking down Jerusalem. The Israelites being sold into slavery. What man can predict these type of things, events? World War I and World War II was prophesied in the scriptures. What man can do that? World War III is prophesied in the scriptures. It's not Russia threatening nuclear war, China threatening to invade Taiwan and take Far East Asia. See? So this is out of this world, literally. Come on.
Verse 6, and it reads, "Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect."
Oh, we do what?
"Speak wisdom among them that are perfect."
The elect. So the elect have already been sealed, perfected, nurtured, already tilled, but now has to be continually watered. Perfect are the elect, those that are sealed for redemption. Come on.
Once more, verse 6, and it reads, "Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught."
See, the princes of this world come to naught. So all the ancient empires, the Assyrian Empire, the Babylonian Empire, the Medo-Persian Empire, the Greek or the Greco-Roman Empire, was built on man-made wisdom, philosophies, not on the eternal pillars of wisdom. So all of these empires fail. America is falling. The dollar has lost 30% of its purchase power and is on the verge of collapse. America is $31 trillion in debt. So all of these man-made pillars are of sand, unsure foundations. You see that? So it's falling because it's not tapped into the eternal life source, a spiritual level of insight. Come on.
First Corinthians.
Read that last part again, Mubba Kishai.
First Corinthians chapter 2, verse 6, once more, and it reads, howbeit we speak wisdom.
Howbeit
we speak wisdom, Salaki, among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught.
That come to naught. So the princes of the dukes of Edom are falling. The international bankers, the Rothschilds, the Vanderbilts, the Oppenheimers, the DuPonts, the princes of the dukes of Edom, Romans. See? What happened to the first Roman Empire? It fell. You see that? See that? So these are the princes of this world that are not grounded in the doctrine of the Most High. Like the sons of Jacob. You got Sherala. That's Israel. When you go into the Hebrew, he is a prince of the power. The Israelite men, the so-called Negro men, are tapped into the eternal power source. Come on.
Verse 7, and it reads, but we speak the wisdom of the Most High in a mystery.
Woo! Come on.
Even the hidden wisdom which the Most High ordained before the world unto our glory.
See that? And we're going to read it again, but you know what? I got a cousin that's in Islam, bugged out of his damn mind, and always want to call me and talk. So it is a mystery to him. A bugged out Negro with dry lips and ashy elbows and can't close his damn mouth. So this is a mystery. It's hidden. That's what makes it a treasure. So the elect have stumbled upon this treasure by divine order, by divine prowess. Manifest destiny is what we're reading about. Manifest destiny. So this is by being ordained, pre-selected. Let's read that again about that hidden wisdom.
Once more, verse 7. And it reads, but we speak the wisdom of the Most High in a mystery, even a hidden wisdom, which the Most High ordained before the world unto our glory. Verse 8, and it reads, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
So they didn't even know that the Messiah was walking the earth, whom you ignorantly called Jesus Christ. He was prophesied in the Old Testament, but you dumb niggas crucified him because you don't understand the mystery. See that? So you killed him. He think he better than us. He think he knows more than us. Ordinary men are not out here on these streets. We are not ordinary men. But a lot of these orangutans and chimps, they killed the Messiah, looking at him like he's on equal ground, like he's an ordinary man. Let's read that again about these dumbasses that killed the Messiah, because they don't understand the mysteries.
Once more, verse 8, and it reads, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would have not have crucified the Lord of glory. Verse 9, and it reads, but as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man, the things which the Most High had prepared for them that love him.
See, so this vision, this eternal kingdom of glory, is only evident in the minds of the elect. We are visionaries. We can see. That's why many people can't understand what we're saying. Because we can fine-tune our frequency, our channel, to match the Most High through Yahawashi. So we are operating on a heavenly frequency. Our channel is tuned in. Not the CNN, the Caveman News Network, but the fourth dimension. So we can see the kingdom in our hearts and minds. We can see it in visions, dreams. How can you talk about something that you can't see? Woo! So the prophets are seers, visionaries. So we see the fourth dimension. We see the promises. Every CEO envisioned his company first or corporation. But if you're on the low vibration, all you can see is Starbucks, Burger King, and Western Sizzler Steakhouse. You can't see beyond this third realm. Come on, read that again, Bubba Kashab Malak.
Once more, verse 9. And it reads, but as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which the Most High have prepared for them that love him.
See, so the elect are a small remnant of Israel that love the Most High. We love what we can't see in the physical realm. So we have a spiritual antenna that's been calibrated, pre-selected to be on his wavelength. That's why we're in love with this word. We don't even know why we're in love with it. So we've been pre-programmed to receive this message. It's not meant for the average Joe Smo, six-pack beer-drinking devil. Come on.
Verse 10, and it reads, but the Most High have revealed them unto us by his spirit.
By his what?
By his spirit.
See, this is a spiritual operating system. How can you operate on the Most High's software if you have not received the software download? Walking around with dry lips and ashy elbows. See? Let's read that again, Bubba Kashai, about that spirit.
Once more, verse 10, and it reads, but the Most High have revealed them unto us by his spirit. For the spirit searcheth all things.
The spirit searcheth all things. We told you that the chariots of the Lord were coming. Most of you did not believe until they announced it on mainstream TV, standing up a UFO task force. Who told you that the chariots of the Lord were present, pre-postured, operating in the outer firmament before the announcement on mainstream TV? Who told you World War III is approaching before North Korea, Russia, and China was threatening World War III? How can we tell you these things if we're not operating in the spirit of the Most High? Who told you that we're going to be digitally marked, tracked, and tagged by a digital Bluetooth system, the Internet of Things, and be linked in digitally? Who told you? Those that are spiritually endowed with the gift of heavenly wisdom. Let's read that again, Bubba Kashai, that last part.
For the spirit search of all things, yea, the deep things of the Most High.
The deep things of the Most High. So we have the secrets. We have the meats. The meats. I'm going to go to Amos 3 and 7. There's somebody out there bogged out right now, King. They don't know what the hell we're talking about. You see? But if we was talking about fried chicken, you know, or a backyard barbecue, or going out to the club with Eve backing that thing up, you would have their undivided attention. This is not for low-level Negroes. That's why we tell you, there's the door. Keep it moving. Amos 3 and 7. Surely the Lord
will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets.
Why you think our videos are being shadow banned?
Deleted. Channels taken down. Videos removed. The caveman knows what the hell is going on. The international bankers, the global elite. You don't get to be a trillionaire by being a goddamn idiot. They know something you don't know. You don't get to be a trillionaire without certain level of wisdom and knowledge. But the prophets are operating on the highest frequency. They know this. Let's read that again. Amos 3, verse 7.
Surely the Lord will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets.
So we told you that Russia was going to threaten World War III, nuclear missiles. We told you China was going to threaten to take Far East Asia, along with North Korea. We told you that a digital money or monetary system is coming to link us in to the grid. We told you that's already being implemented. But we told you several years ago. Come on.
Once more, verse 10. But the Most High had revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of the Most High. Verse 11, and it reads, for what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him?
See that? So this is a spiritual gift that comes from on high. I'm going to go to Job 32. Job 32. Book of Job, chapter 32, verse 7. I said, days should speak, and multitude of years should teach wisdom. As we get older, we acquire wisdom, theoretically. But let's see where this is going. I said, days should speak, and multitude of years should teach wisdom, but there is a spirit in men, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding. So this wisdom comes from on high. You can't touch it. You can't see it. But what you can't see is more powerful than what you can see. Try telling somebody that just lost their house from a tornado or a hurricane and tell them that wind is not dangerous because you can't see the wind. But it can pick up momentum like the Spirit. It can shift and redirect. It can shape shift. See? Let me go here. I'm going to go to John. Try telling somebody that the wind that you can't see is harmless and they just lost their home to a hurricane or a tornado. I'm going to go to John 3. Book of John, chapter 3. One moment. Right here. John chapter 3, verse 7. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth. So is every one that is born of the Spirit. For the men of the Lord are like the wind. You don't know where we're going to spring up or come forth. You don't know which direction we're heading in, because we can redirect, shape, and shift the message based on the Holy Spirit. So this cannot be calculated or weighed in the balance. It cannot be measured. There are no metrics for the power from on high of the Holy Spirit. Come on.
Once more, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. And it reads, for what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him, even so the things of the Most High knoweth no man, but the spirit of the Most High. Verse 12, and it reads, now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of the Most High, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of the Most High. Verse 13, and it reads, which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, compares spiritual things with spiritual. Verse 14, but the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of the Most High, for they are foolishness unto him.
They are what?
Foolishness unto him.
Many people look at us like this is foolish. That's because they're in a secular world. They're walking in the flesh. They're not tuned in to what we can't see. The spirit of the wind, a heavenly realm. So they just walk by us and mock and scoff. But it's amazing to me, where are the UFO scoffers now? We told you niggas that the UFOs were the chariots of the Lord and that they were coming. Now that mainstream media, CNN, have announced it, your allegiance to your slave master did not fail. You stood up straight and narrow, ready to go at your service, slave. But we told you through the Spirit of the Lord what was going down. They're here for judgment. We told you this. We told you that the electronic tracking, tagging device is going to be implemented. They're already pushing forth laws through the Human Infrastructure Bill. Look up the Human Infrastructure Bill. This thing is going to be mandated where you can't buy, you can't sell, you can't travel unless you're tracked like cattle. Let me go here to Isaiah. Isaiah Yep, see? The book of Isaiah, chapter 44. I'm going to go to verse 6. Isaiah 44, verse 6. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last, and besides me, there is no God. We just read the Most High and the Son or the King of the Most High, whom we ignorantly call Jesus Christ. I'm gonna read it again. So you watch this. Isaiah 44, verse 6. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel and his Redeemer. See? And his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last, and besides me there is no God. Who is that first and the last? I'm going to show you. See, watch this. I'm going to go to Revelations. It's talking about Yahweh Shai, whom we ignorantly call Jesus Christ. See, it's right here. Revelation 1, verse 8. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, saith the Lord, which is and which was and which is to come, the Almighty. So he's going to come a second time to redeem the elect. See that Alpha, the first, and the Omega. The same thing we read in Isaiah chapter 44. See, John, Revelation 1, verse 9. I, John, who also am your brother and companion in tribulation and in the kingdom and patience of Hamashiach Yahweh Shai, was in the isle that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Yahweh Shai Hamashiach. copy that? So that first and that last is Yahweh Shai. The Most High is what? The Ancient of Days. He has no beginning, no ending. There's a difference. Let's go back to Isaiah 44, verse 6. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts. I am the first, and I am the last. And besides me, there is no power. And who, as I shall call, and shall declare it, and set it in order for me, since I appointed the ancient people, and the things that are coming, and shall come, let them show unto thee. See? So this is how we're able to prophesy the things that shall come. We can't do that without a gift from the Most High. Let me read that again. Isaiah 44, verse 7. And who, as I shall call, and shall declare it, and set it in order for me, since I appointed the ancient people, and the things that are coming and shall come, let them show unto them. The ancient people are the prophets. Ancient spirits are on a higher operating level than the president, than Donald Trump, Joe Biden. See? Kim Jong-un, North Korea. What's his name from Russia? Vladimir Putin. Okay, they're all on a low level.
Okay. 1 Corinthians, chapter 2. Once more, verse 14. And it reads, but the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of the Most High. For they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. Verse 15, and it reads, but he that is spiritual judgeth all things.
Who are the ancient people? Read that again.
But he that is spiritual judgeth all things.
So the ancient people are on the earth bringing forth righteous words from on high. So the judgments are embedded in prophecy. America is prophesied to be destroyed by fire, by stealing land, murdering and slaughtering the Native Americans, invading and colonizing the earth, spreading opioids and heroin throughout the earth, and pharmaceuticals, poisonous toxins, invading Far East Asia, Indonesia, Korea, Japan, Philippines, Vietnam, Korea. See? So the ancient people are set as a counterbalance against evil, against the Edomites, Romans. So you have good set against evil. So the ancient men are here to help bring the earth back into balance. A universal order. Let's read that again about he that is spiritual judgeth all things.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 15, once more, and it reads, but he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judge of no man.
So the ambassadors from on high are on the earth. Why you think the videos keep getting taken down? So the international elite, they know who the ancient spirits are. They know. How do we know what they know? Based on their actions. Panic, fear, YouTube guidelines. Now the truth or the Bible is being misrepresented as hate speech. See that? So we know that they know who we are based on their actions. I mean, if you've ever played chess, you know what level your opponent is on based on his moves. You know if you're dealing with a student or amateur or a master teacher. So the caveman is operating on the master level, on the left-hand side. The international bankers, the global elite, shadow ban these Negroes, strike them, community guidelines strike. That's hate speech. That's not hate speech, nigga. This is the Bible. How can that be hate speech? You see? Come on.
Verse 16, and it reads, for who have known the mind of the Lord Yahweh Babashim Yahushah, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of HaMashiach Yahushah.
No, we're just a bunch of average Negroes walking around with nothing else better to do. Read that again, Bubba Kashah.
Once more, verse 16, and it reads, for who have known the mind of the Lord Yahweh Babashim Yahushah, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of HaMashiach Yahushah.
We are not ordinary men. If you're walking in the spirit, you see that. How in the world can regular men cause a reshift and reshaping of YouTube guideline policies? A new directive on government laws and policies. You see, now, if you don't have at least 500 subscribers, you can't go live. Now, if you speak out against the small hats, then that's a constitutional infraction for promoting hate. If you speak out against the small hat, little big nose people, if I say it, they'll take down the video. So ordinary men cannot reshape and redirect policy, government. So this word has a power to move mountains. What are mountains? Governments. Ordinary men cannot move governments, policy, provisions. What is provisions? Everything included in the law, statutes, and guidelines of the government. Only above average men can do that. Let's read that again, please, about that that line.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 16, once more, and it reads, for who have known the mind of the Lord Yahweh Babashim Yahushah, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of HaMashiach Yahushah.
See, so we gotta take our time. When we're reading this, Yahushah calls a major move or movement under the Roman government. So we're doing the same thing in these last days. Government guidelines are being created. New hate speech regulations are being implemented. You see that? So we gotta take our time. So the same spirit of whom we ignorantly call Jesus Christ is operating in the earth today. And he was a so-called black man with woolly hair. That is who is causing fear, trembling. The so-called Negroes of Judah, the head tribe. And now the other tribes are following suit. The other 11 tribes.
Visit the comment board.
Let me go to the comment board. Brother Sadat. Brother Sadat, Amram, House of David. Ezekiel 3, verse 27. But when I speak with thee, I will open thy mouth. And thou shalt say unto them, thus saith the Lord God, he that heareth, let them hear, and he that forbeareth, let him forbear. For they are a rebellious house. So this is not our words. There is no such thing as free will. So he's putting his words in our mouth.
We got something I'm going to go to. I'll hand this to you in a minute. Right there. This is spirit. So, transition to this.
Let's see if there's any such thing as free will.
Free will. Second Thessalonians, chapter 3, verse 5, and it reads, "In the Lord Yahweh, Baba Shem Yahweh, direct your hearts into the love of the Most High."
And see, see that? Direct. So we're being directed, mentally and spiritually programmed. There is no free will. Let's read that again, Baba Kishan.
Once more, 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 5, and it reads, "In the Lord Yahweh Baba Shem Yahweh Shai, direct your hearts into the love of the Most High and into the patient waiting for Yahweh Shai HaMashiach."
Yep. See? And we're going to go to the next one, Jeremiah 10 and 23.
Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 23. And it reads, "O Lord Yahweh, I know that the way of man is not in himself. It is not in man that walketh to direct his steps."
See? "Order my steps in your word." We used to sing that in church. "Order my steps in your word, dear Lord. Lead me, guide me." See that? So we're being directed. This is why government policy is being reshaped, reconsidered, thought out, changed. So this is the power to move mountains, which means governments. Come on.
Second Esdras, chapter 15, verse 1, and it reads, "Behold, speak down in the ears of my people the words of prophets, which I have put in thy mouth."
Which what?
"Put in thy mouth."
"Which I have put in thy mouth,"
said the Lord Yahweh Baba Shem Yahweh Shai.
Let's read that again.
Once more, 2 Esdras, chapter 15, verse 1, and it reads, "Behold, speak down in the ears of my people the words of prophets, which I will put in thy mouth," said the Lord Yahweh Baba Shem Yahweh Shai.
See? So this is a program. Why do you think we call the Bible scriptures? This is a script. The Most High Power is the greatest movie director of all time. What power you know can move or influence a trillionaire, an international banker? What natural man you know? An average Negro walking around with his ass showing, his drawers showing, hands sagging off, can bring fear into an international global elite. What natural man you know can cause great fear upon the nations? China, Russia, Korea, North Korea, Japan, the Middle East, Saudi Arabia, North America, South America. See? Let's go to Proverbs 16.
Proverbs chapter 16, verse 1, and it reads, "The preparations of the heart in man and the answer of the tongue is from the Lord Yahweh."
No, just a bunch of disgruntled Negroes that don't know what the hell they're talking about. So our heart is our mind. See? So the frequency of the prophets are operating on the highest level of masculinity on earth. Brokebacks are being dismayed. Wicked ass Negroes are being dismayed. The caveman and the caveman news network, CNN, are being dismayed. They're losing their mind. They can't wrap their hands around the wind, the spirit of the power from the fourth dimension. they're being made crazy. The Bible says that make diviners mad. Let's read that again in Proverbs 16.
Once more, Proverbs chapter 16, verse 1, and it reads, the preparations of the heart and man, and the answer of the tongue, is from the Lord your house. Proverbs.
See? So there is no free will. Let's go to Proverbs 16 and 4.
Proverbs chapter 16, verse 4, and it reads, the Lord Yahweh hath made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked for the day of evil.
Even the wicked. The wicked are the Edomites, Romans, the same men that killed Yahawashi, because they did not understand the spiritual prophecies in this book. They did not understand the Messiah was foretold to come. So we had the wisdom of our Lord and Savior, whom we ignorantly call Jesus Christ. So they killed him, Romans, Edomites, followed by a two-third wicked set of Israelites. See? But we understand that this is all by divine design. All by divine design. Let's go back to Proverbs 16 and 4.
Once more, Proverbs chapter 16, verse 4, and it reads, the Lord Yahweh hath made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked for the day of evil.
And we know the wicked are Romans, Edomites. That is who is in rulership. 2nd Ezra 6, verse 9 says, for Esau is the end of the world, Jacob is the beginning of it. That follow. So we're under the wicked, their tyranny. Look up Job 9 and 24. Let's go to Jeremiah 51, verse 7.
Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 7. And it reads, Babylon has been a golden cup in the Lord Yahweh's hand that made all the earth drunken. The nations have drunken of her wine. Therefore, the nations are mad.
So this is the floor plan, the movie script that America would be used as a vessel, a vehicle to make all the other nations follow white supremacy, modern day Christianity, feminism, women's liberation. You got women in Iran twerking, see? That made all the nations drunk. That means crazy as hell. Bugged out. Following this hoe, the daughter of Babylon. You got women in Saudi Arabia twerking. Okay? So the other nations are following her ways. But notice the scripture said that she has been a cup in the Lord's hand. So the Lord is sending the strong delusion, wickedness. Come on. We're going to go to Isaiah 49 and 2.
Isaiah chapter 49, verse 2, and it reads, and he hath made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand have he hidden.
He made our mouth a weapon. So our mouth pierces and pricks and slay the works of darkness and evil. Child pedophilia, feminism, women's liberation, white supremacy, all bullshit. So our word is of the Most High, which is a razor sharp tongue. That's why the videos are being taken down. Shadow banned. The wicked are being slain by the word, a two-edged sword. Let's read that again about our mouths.
Isaiah chapter 49, verse 2, and it reads, and he hath made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand have he hidden and made me a polished shaft. In his quiver have he hidden.
See, we are the hidden ones. the world just thinks we're just a bunch of average Negroes. We're just angry black men, so to speak. Well, kiss my ass. No, we're not. We're following a script. Okay? This is not a man-made movement. It's a spiritual order, a decree from on high. So if we're a bunch of jesters or clowns, why are the global elites making United Nations guidelines? Why did they stand up an internet task force, a United Nations global task force? Because the word cuts, the sword swings left and right, and the sword pierces through the soul of the wicked. So if you think we're a game, why are they standing up a UN internet task force? New guidelines, regulations, govern what we say. Let's go from there. We're gonna go to Isaiah 51.
Isaiah chapter 51, verse 16.
Come on.
And it reads, and I have put my words in their mouth.
No, this is just our own bullshit.
And I have put my words in thy mouth.
Come on.
And I have covered thee in the shadow of my hand, that I may plant the heavens and lay the foundations of the earth.
So the elect are being planted. The kings of the earth are being made known, visible. We're standing up. We were told we are just niggas. We're just slaves. We're just Negroes, Spicks, Sambos. You see? But now the heavens is being planted. That means a new age of rulership under Jacob. Remember, 2nd Ezra 6 and 9. Esau, which is the so-called white man, is the end of the world. Jacob is the beginning of it that followed. So the heavens of the tabernacle of David is being planted, standing up bold as lions in these last days. Man, that damn near knocked me out. We gotta read that again.
Isaiah chapter 51, verse 16, and it reads, and I have put my words in thy mouth, and I have covered thee in the shadow of my hand, that I may plant the heavens and lay the foundations of the earth, and say unto Zion, thou art my people.
And say unto Zion, the Israelites, thou art my people. See? So we were hidden in the quiver of the Lord, the hidden ones. We were told we're just Gentiles. We were told we are nobodies, no name in the street. We were told we are a no people. When in that place where it was said unto thee, ye are not my people, there it shall be said unto thee, ye are the sons of the living God. So what is Israel in Hebrew? Yasharallah. He is a prince of the power. We got to read that again. That's got a lot of firepower.
Once more, Isaiah chapter 51, verse 16, and it reads, and I have put my words in thy mouth, and I have covered thee in the shadow of my hand, that I may plant the heavens and lay the foundations of the earth, and say unto Zion, thou art my people.
See, Zion, the Israelites. Notice the foundations of the earth. So the pillars of wisdom has been laid, starting with the chief cornerstone, whom we ignorantly call Jesus. His name is Yahawashai, Hamashiach, not Jesus Christ. He is a so-called Negro man with woolly hair. So the pillars of wisdom are being established on the earth. The rebar has been laid. The concrete has been poured. The tempered mortar is now being spread forth. The spirit that drives and search all things is driving our motor, driving our engine. Let's go to Jeremiah 1. Verse 9. So we got somebody out there thinking that we're just a bunch of disgruntled, angry Negroes. We ain't got nothing else better to do. Let's see if you're the devil that the Bible speaks of. Let's go to Jeremiah 1, verse 9.
Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 9. And it reads, then the Lord your house put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord Yahweh said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth.
See? So this is a script. Why you think we call it the scriptures? This is a movie we're in that has been written. A narrative has already been written and declared from on high. This is not man-made. No man can move governments like this or mountains in the analogous term. For his words have been sown in our heart, which is our mind. One more time, Bubba Kashat.
Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 9. And it reads, then the Lord Yahweh put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord Yahweh said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth.
Beautiful.
We're going to go to, okay.
Jeremiah chapter 5, verse 14. And it reads, wherefore thus said the Lord Yahweh, our power of hosts, because ye speak this word, behold, I will make my words in thy mouth fire.
I will make my words in thy mouth fire. Let's read that again.
Jeremiah chapter 5, verse 14. And it reads, wherefore thus said the Lord Yahweh, our power of hosts, because ye speak this word, behold, I will make my words in thy mouth fire. And this people would. Yeah. And it shall devour them.
It shall devour them. See? So the deeds of the wicked, light is being shed upon them. Where are the 750,000 missing children? Esau, Edom. Where are the 1 million missing collectively? Adults, men, women, and children here in America. And globally, 8 million. Who is the wicked that are in rulership? The child sex rings, pedophiles, the wicked global elite. Who's contaminating our food and water so they can make trillions of dollars off of us through a multi-trillion dollar pharmaceutical drug industry? So the words we speak is a sharp sword and a devouring flame, devouring the souls of the wicked. Let's go to Hosea.
Hosea chapter 6, verse 5, and it reads, therefore have I hewed them by the prophets. I have slain them by the words of my mouth.
I have done what?
Slain them by the words of my mouth.
Come on.
And thy judgments are as the light that goeth forth.
So this is a sentencing phase. The global elites understand they're being read their rights. You have a right to remain silent, nigga. Everything you say and have done shall be held against you in the court of law, waging illegal wars, colonizing the goddamn earth, Spain, France, Asia, China, Korea, Philippines, Indonesia, Australia, Central America, South America, Japan. See? So you're being devoured by truth. We don't get down with emotions. We're going to tell you you're the devil that the Bible speaks of. And you got Eve in bed with you. Eve, following the snake in the grass. Esau, Edom, the devil. Romans. So we're going to slay you and cut you in half by the word of the living water. Let's go back to Hosea.
Hosea chapter 6, verse 5, and it reads, therefore have I hewed them by the prophets, I have slain them by the words of my mouth, and thy judgments are as the light that goeth forth.
Remember in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, we read that we judge all things. Remember that? So the prophets are judges. I know you caught that. So sentence go forth first by the prophets. That's why we went to 1 Corinthians chapter 2. That he that is spiritual judgeth all things. Let's go from there. We're going to go to Proverbs, verse 16 and 9.
Proverbs chapter 16, verse 9. And it reads, a man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord Yahweh directeth his steps.
See? So we think that the decisions we make, it's just instant, like instant coffee, instantaneous. The earth and the universe is governed by a spiritual force. I ran into a witch not too long ago. She understood this. She said, yeah, we know if we choose white magic, then our punishment will be less on us when we get reincarnated and come back in the next life. But we know if we do black magic, we'll have a severe punishment when we come back in the next life. She understood this. So the earth is governed by universal laws from on high, the Most High, Yahweh. See that? Let's go to Psalms 37.
Psalms chapter 37, verse 23, and it reads, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord Yahweh, and he delighteth in his way.
See, the steps of a good man, the prophets are the servants, the prophets, the apostles, the teachers, the steps of a good man, the servants of the Lord, and the remnant of the hopeful elect are following this way. This is the way, walk ye in it. So shepherds have been erected, leaders. That's what we're seeing on the earth in these last days, calling out all the global bullshit. You see, we're not afraid of being politically correct. We don't have to be politically correct. We're speaking a knowledge from the chief executive officer of the universe. You see, a CEO that governs the world. So to hell with being politically correct. I'll speak that again about the steps of a good man.
Psalms chapter 37, verse 23. Once more, and it reads, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord Yahweh, and he delighteth in his way.
And he delighteth in his way. See? So the Most High sees this as an acceptable burnt offering, an acceptable sacrifice by doing the work, being a man. A lot of you Eves hook up with niggas, and then you complain. You got about somewhere around 30% of the so-called Negro men are married. There's another somewhere around 50 to 51% are single and childless. About 18%, give or take, are single, okay? And they're popping the same women. The 18% single men are all sleeping with the same women. About 30% married, about 50 to 51% are single and childless. About 18% are not married, but have multiple children by different women, or bouncing around to different women. But the markings or the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Well ordered. Let's close out with Isaiah 46.
Isaiah chapter 46, verse 10, and it reads, declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times and the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure.
Declaring the end from the beginning. So the script has already been written out. The narrative has already been approved and signed off on. See? So everything has been ordered. The universe is weighed in the balance. Everything is set, good against evil, prophets against the wicked, the child molesting pedophiles of the global elites and their underlings, the national leaders. To hell with these leaders. We don't even recognize their authority when they're going off like that. And we're not going to take your damn doggy tracking tagging device. Okay, go to hell and drop dead. How's that for a tracking device? Okay, the C-hip, or the M to the O to the T to the B. When we prophesied about that, we were mocked and scoffed and made fun of. Now they're openly mentioning it on the mainstream. Okay? They're telling you what they're getting ready to do. Let's read that again, 46 and 10. Isaiah, please.
Once more, Isaiah chapter 46, verse 10, and it reads, declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure.
The Most High's counsel stands. This is not man-made. No man can shape a universal or an international policy. No normal man can do that. Let's get that about. You should be able to move mountains.
Matthew chapter 21, verse 20, and it reads, and when the disciples saw it, they marveled, saying, how soon is the fig tree withered away? Verse 21, and it reads, Yahweh shall answer and say unto them, verily I say unto you, if ye have faith and doubt not, ye should not only do this which is done to the fig tree, but also if ye say, ye shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, it should be done.
The mountain is the last governing authority. We're under the revised Roman Empire. That's the mountain of Edom, the so-called white man. So this is the second beast that was prophesied to re-emerge into prominence. You see, the last governing authority or empire. So this mountain is being moved by the word. This is a spiritual force. This is not a man-made event. Governments shape and shift. Leaders are removed. Empires crumble because of the simple preaching of the word. One more time, Bubba Kishah, verse 21.
Matthew chapter 21, verse 21. And it reads, Yahweh shall answer and said unto them, verily I say unto you, if ye have faith and doubt not, ye should not only do this which is done to the fig tree, but also, if ye shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, it should be done.
So this place is being threatened with nuclear missiles. So the landmass is prophesied to be cast into the sea, literally. And it's going to be broken into three, a landmass of the United States. See? So that starts with prophesying. Years ago, it was insane to mention nuclear war. Now Russia is openly threatening nuclear war. North Korea has always done that, but Russia is the major superpower, Gog and Magog, mentioned in the scriptures. So that's a key player to pay attention to, along with Iran, their ally. See? So what are we seeing? A semblance of the re-emergence of the ancient Medo-Persian alliance. Iran, Russia, see? Egypt, Libya, Turkey, and the former Soviet Union bloc nations. What man can tell you that this is going to occur 2,500 years before it happens? No man on earth. I'm gonna go ahead and end it there. Pray for me. I'm feeling kind of weak today. A little nauseous and dizzy. Probably dehydrated. So hopefully this has been edifying. It's going to be clear and simple to the remnant or the hopeful elect. But if you're a bug out, you don't have the seed pre-planted. The word educate comes from the Latin educare, which means to bring out. So the seed is already planted in the minds of the elect. That are just being nurtured by the fountains of living waters and springing forth and outward by the sun rays or the Holy Spirit, the light. Like to turn to the east and give all praises to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai Bashem Kwakadash. Double honor and respect to the elders, the apostles, the great millstone. Much respect and honor. Much respect and honor to the brothers doing the work and truth and sincerity, risking their lives and freedom to do so. Pushing this gospel throughout the four corners of the earth. Salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. Kwame Yasharala and Abad Babel. We got next, Lord willing. Much love and respect to the beloved ladies of the hopeful elect of the house of David. Shalom, Barakatan.
Shalom, Barakatan.